Yeah, welcome back to the third hour and the analysis of cables. We dealt three problems wherein in all the problems both the supports are at same level. We'll see how to analyze, how to solve a problem with a cable if end supports are at different levels. Here is a problem. A cable is suspended from points A and B, which are 80 meter apart. This horizontal distance is 80 meter and are at different levels. The point A is being 5 meter vertically higher than the point B. Here, this is 5 meter above the B level. And the lowest point of the cable is 10 meter below A. This is maximum dip, 10 meter. Cable is subjected to a UDL, uniformly distributed load, of 30 kilonewton per meter over the horizontal span. Determine the horizontal and vertical reaction at each end, here and here. Also determine the horizontal and vertical each end, also maximum tension in the cable. We know maximum tension will be at supports. It may be at A or it may be at B. We'll see that later. Now this is the diagram for the problem. You should draw figure carefully reading the question. A and B are the supports. Let H and VA, or HA and VA are the horizontal and vertical reaction at A. HB and VB are the horizontal and vertical reactions at B. Now we have to find the reactions. Now, let C be the lowest point. At the lowest point, tensile force is horizontal and is obviously equal to H. Okay. This is the problem here. A cable, they are at different levels. Let HA and VA, HB and VB are the horizontal and vertical reactions at A and B. Now we know for equilibrium, if you apply sigma fx is equal to 0, no other horizontal forces, therefore HA is equal to HB, that's equal to H. Now this is subjected to an UDL. Magnitude of the UDL is 30 kilonewton per meter over a span of, it is given, 80 meter. Okay. Now let C is the lowest point and it is given. It is 10 meter below the support A. This is point C. At the lowest point here, we know force in the cable, that is tensile force in the cable, is horizontal and is obviously equal to HA or HB or H. Okay, we'll call it as H. Now HA is equal to HB. Let the distance between A and C, this is L1, horizontal distance, and the distance between C and B, it is this L2. If both are at same level, the bottommost point is symmetrical because of UDL, and L1 is equal to L2, L1 plus L2 will be 80 meter. But now L1 and L2 are different. Now moment equilibrium condition, the cable is in equilibrium. If you apply sigma MA is equal to 0, HA and VA will be 0. And HB and VB will create moment about A, and that will be about this. HB creates like this, it is anti-clockwise, minus HB into its distance, this is difference in height between A and B is given as 5 meter. Therefore, HB into 5, HB into 5, then VB No. This is, I take not A, sigma MC is equal to 0 by considering right side. HA into 5, Okay. Now here, it is about, I'll just 1 minute. I'll write here. Sigma MA is equal to 0. Sigma MA is equal to 0 means HA and VA will be 0. Here this T about A, it creates moment like this. It is anticlockwise. That is minus H into 10, and this UDL creates like this clockwise plus L1 into L1 into its perpendicular distance of the length L1 by 2 from A. That is by considering this H. For this condition, this is C. Only T is equal to H. This is H. This is VA. About this, we are taking the moment. This HA into 0, HA into 0, VA into 0. Minus H into, this is 10 meter, correct? H into 10 plus UDL here, that is for a length of L1, therefore this is 30, that is 30 into L1 by 2 is equal to 0. Now sigma MB is equal to 0 by considering left side. Now here this portion of the arch is considered HB, VB, this is T, or it is H, this is C, UDL 30. Now this is 5 meter. This is 10 minus 5 here. B and C level is 5 meter. Now sigma MB by considering left side, it is HB into 0, VB into 0, H like this clockwise plus H into 2, its distance is 5 meter. minus this one, like this. It is anti-clockwise, minus 30 into its length is L2, that is 30 into L2 into L2 by 2 is equal to 0. Got it? No? If you use these two equations, H you can replace, we will get equations in terms of, that is 30 L1 squared by 2 is equal to 30 L2 squared by 2 into 2, because 10H is equal to 10H and 5H are there, therefore 5H is equal to this, therefore 10H will be equal to 10H. If you make this throughout by 2, multiply, it will be this. Now, also, that is this. Now, L1 squared from this, W by 2 will cancel. Therefore, L1 squared is equal to L2 squared. Sorry, 2L2 squared. WW will cancel. 30 will cancel. This 2 will cancel. Therefore, 2L1 squared is equal to 2L2 squared. But from the geometry of the arch, we know L1 plus L2 is equal to 80. Therefore, by solving this and this equation, L1 L2 is 33.L2 will be 33.137 meter, and therefore L1 will be 80 minus 33.137. It will be 46.863 meter. That is, L1 and L2 can be formed. Now, if you substitute that is here in this equation or in this equation, we can calculate the value of H. W 30 it is known, L1 and L2 is known, therefore H can be calculated. That is, if you substitute here in this or in this, H can be calculated, and H we get will be kilonewton. Okay, that is HA or HB will be the horizontal reaction. Okay. Now, considering that is H, considering the equilibrium of vertical forces on AC, that is vertical forces on the equilibrium of AC, this one we can write plus VA plus VA minus 80 into L1, it is 46.863 meter equal to 0, because here no vertical force. From this VK, VA we can calculate, and it is 1405.89 kilonewton. Now, by considering equilibrium of the portion CB, here vertical force will not be there. That means plus VB, that is in the portion AB, sorry, AC. Here it is for BC, sigma FY is equal to 0. Plus VB minus 80 into, sorry, not 80, intensity of the UDL. Here also it is not 80, it is 30, intensity of the UDL. Here 30 into L2, this length, it is acting down. L2, 33.137 is equal to 0. From this VB we can calculate, and it is 994.11 kilonewton. That is VA and VB are over. Now they ask you to find maximum tension. See, VA and VB is over by considering the equilibrium portion. Now, maximum tension, that is tension here and tension here, 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 that is TA and this is TB. Now, they ask you to find the maximum tension. It is very clear. HA is equal to HB. Therefore, TA and TB depends on VA and VB. As VA is more here, TA will be maximum. That is, TA will be Tmax. And it is VA squared plus HA squared or H squared under square root. VA 1405.89 square plus H we found and it is 3294. Point 2 whole squared. We get T max as 3581.66 kilonewton. That is what it is shown here. It is VA is more than VB. Therefore, maximum tension occurs at A and this T max is this much 3581.66 kilonewton. This is the answer. You clear? Just here is the thing, the cable is supported at different levels. What we have to do is we have to consider free body diagram of A to C and C to B separately, because C at C only horizontal force will act, that is here. A to C free body diagram once considered, C to be considered. As the cable is in equilibrium, the portion of the cable between A to C is also in equilibrium, C to B is also in equilibrium. By considering A to C and applying sigma MA is equal to 0, this T or H into 10 minus WL squared by this UDL L1 squared that I explained already. And from this H you can substitute in either of the equation. We will get this. And from this, L1 squared is equal to 2L2 squared. Also, the total length, that is 80 meter, should be equal to L1 plus L2. Therefore, from this, L1 and L2 can be calculated. If you substitute that L1 or L2 here, in the any one of the equation, we get horizontal reaction. Now considering the equilibrium of the again same portions, AC and CB, applying sigma FY is equal to 0, VA and VB can be found here. Once if we get VA and VB, maximum tension will be at support, we know. And as HA is equal to HB, maximum tension depends upon the magnitude of VA. as VA and or VB. As VA is more, maximum tension will be at A, and therefore by substituting VA here, we can calculate the maximum tension. Suppose if further in the backstay our ankle cable is given, the remaining analysis will be same as the previous problem what we dealt here, depending upon the saddle support or depending upon the pulley support. Now that is about the cable supported at different levels. Now these are the problems with suspenders. Now as per your syllabus, there is another topic in the same cable that is in the module 5, that is supports at same and different level, it is over. Now then cables with stiffening trusses for suspension cable. Stiffening trusses, that means it will be we know cable will be like this, maybe at same level or at different level. This will be provided with trusses like this, stiffening girder means. Now stiffening girder, it is a heavy beam like this with trusses. Now this truss may be with any number of inches. As we are discussing 3-inched, we consider, because statically determinate, we will be having inches at support at the ends and one more inch at the maximum dip level, that is the third hinge. Now here, if stiffening girder may be subjected to some point loads also like this, but this will be transferred to the cable as like UDL, because there are number of suspenders. Finally, the load acting on this will be as like UDL. Therefore, because of this, there will be reactions at the end, stiffening girder, that is RA and RB. And these forces, will be converted into UDL on the stiffening girder, above the stiffening girder, and that equivalent UDL, nothing but WE, will be taken as the load acting on the cable. Now the analysis, once we convert these different types of loadings to an equivalent load on the cable, the analysis will remain same. Now in this stiffening girder with a beam or a truss like this, loaded with different types of loading, converting this into equivalent UDL is the extra analysis in this. Now if you take stiffening girder or with a truss like this, this stiffening girder may be subjected to point loads, I told you, like this, or it may be subjected to UDL, or it may be also subjected to UDL for some length. Now this load W1, this is W2, this is W3 per meter, this is W4 per meter. These all loads acting on whatever may be the load will be converted into equivalent UDL here. For that, we have to analyze this stiffening girder as like a beam or maybe a tension truss. Once we convert this into equivalent load, the analysis of the cable remains same as that of the problems that what we have discussed. Now in the next class, maybe the last hour, I will take the brief analysis of this, how to convert this load into equivalent UDL, and also the numerical problem on this. Okay. Now I'll take that in the next class, because now if I start left with another 5 to 6 minutes, that will also become incomplete. Therefore, I'll take the analysis of that in the next class. Okay. Now we'll meet in the next class, next hour. Okay. Fine. Have a good day.